Hello everyone, in this third video on carbohydrate chemistry, we are going to learn about structural aspects of monosaccharides and different forms of isomerism. To understand the structural aspects of monosaccharides, we need to understand some important terms like asymmetric carbon atom. It is a carbon atom that is attached to four different groups or atoms. For example, this is a structure of glyceraldehyde where this carbon atom is attached to four different groups or atoms, and this carbon atom is called as asymmetric carbon atom. The second term is penultimate or reference carbon atom, and it is the asymmetric carbon atom which is adjacent to the terminal carbon having an hydroxyl group. This is the structure of glucose having six carbon. It is a hexosugar. And the carbon atoms are numbered like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So this fifth carbon atom, which is adjacent to the terminal carbon. Terminal carbon here is carbon number 6. So this fifth carbon atom, which is asymmetric carbon atom, and this is called as reference carbon atom because this is adjacent to the terminal carbon having hydroxyl group. Now, in tetrazoes, there are four carbon atoms are present. So in case of tetrazoes, the third carbon is a reference carbon atom. In pentoses, fourth one is the reference carbon atom. And in hexoses, for example, in case of glucose, the fifth one is reference carbon atom. What is anomeric carbon? The C1 carbon is called as anomeric carbon atom. For example, this is a C1 carbon atom. This is a ring structure of glucose. And this C1 carbon atom is anomeric carbon atom, and the position of hydroxyl group decides whether it is alpha anomer or beta anomer. So these are the three important terms: asymmetric carbon atom, reference carbon atom and anomeric carbon atom. Sugars exhibit various forms of isomerism. What are isomers? These are the compounds possessing identical chemical or molecular formula but different structures. There are various types of isomerism. For example, stereoisomers, D and L isomerism. Second, depending upon the functional group present, there is aldose-ketose isomerism. Depending on the optical activity, there are optical isomers, epimerism, anomerism, and depending upon the presence of pyran and furan ring, there are pyranose and furanose forms of isomerism. Let's begin with the stereoisomers, D and L isomerism. All carbohydrates which have at least one asymmetric carbon atom can exist in different stereoisomeric forms. And these forms have same structural formula, but they differ in spatial configuration. What is spatial configuration? That is the arrangement of atoms or groups in space around the carbon atoms. And most of the stereoisomers that occur in the body, they are of D series. For example, D-glucose, D-fructose. Only few monosaccharides, they occur in L form, like L-xylose, L-xylulose. This is a structure of glyceraldehyde, and this glyceraldehyde is considered as a reference molecule. It is the simplest carbohydrate having three carbon atoms, and it is taken as a reference molecule to determine the D and L isomers of carbohydrates. And this glyceraldehyde, it has three carbons, and this second carbon is asymmetric carbon atom, and it is also a reference carbon atom. So the D and L isomerism depends on the orientation of this H and OH group around this reference carbon atom. So in this case, this OH group is present on the right side, and that's why it is called as D-glyceraldehyde, and here the OH group is present on the left side, and that's why it is L-glyceraldehyde. This is the structure of glucose. Here, the reference carbon atom is carbon number 5. And here, hydroxyl group is present on the right side. It is D-glucose. And here, the hydroxyl group is present on the left side. So, it is L-glucose. And the number of isomers depends on the number of asymmetric carbon atoms present in the sugar. And the D and L isomers, these are the mirror images of each other, and these two forms are also called as enantiomers. And the number of isomers, it is calculated like this. It is equal to 2 raised to the power n. and n is the number of asymmetric carbon atoms in a molecule. For example, glyceraldehyde has only one asymmetric carbon atom. So 2s to the power 1 means 2. So glyceraldehyde has only 2 stereoisomers. Second type of isomerism is aldose-ketose isomerism, and the isomers are called as functional isomers. They have same molecular formula but different functional groups. For example, glucose and fructose, they have same molecular formula, but in glucose, aldehyde group is present, so it is an aldose sugar, though it is a hexose. It contains 6 carbons. Fructose is also hexose sugar, but it contains keto group, so it is a keto sugar. So these are the functional isomers, and the interconversion of these functional isomers is catalyzed by enzyme isomerase. For example, in the glycolysis pathway, glucose 6-phosphate and fructose 6-phosphate, they are interconvertible by the action of enzyme phosphohexose isomerase. What is optical isomerism? It depends on the optical activity. It is the capacity of a substance to rotate the plane polarized light passing through it. And these optical isomers, they have identical composition, but they differ in their direction of rotation of plane polarized light. And the presence of asymmetrical carbon atom causes optical activity. So when a beam of plane polarized light is passed through a solution of carbohydrates having optical activity, if the light is rotated to the left, it is called as dextrorotatory, and it is denoted by plus sign and small d. So D glucose is dextrorotatory. So that capital D is different from this small d. Capital D glucose is a stereoisomeric form, and this small d is a rotation, that is dextrorotatory form. So this D glucose is dextrorotatory, and that's why sometimes it is known as dextrose. And if the rotation of light is towards the right side, it is the levorotatory, which is denoted by minus sign. And D fructose is levorotatory. So the stereoisomers and optical isomers, they are independent properties. That don't get confused between capital D and small d. Capital D form is a stereoisomeric form, and this plus and minus, they are the optical isomeric forms. And natural sugars, they usually are optically active, but synthetic carbohydrates are racemic, which means that they are optically inactive. What does it mean by racemic mixture? When equal amount of dextrorotatory and levorotatory isomers are present, the resulting mixture has no optical activity, and such a mixture is called as racemic mixture. What is epimerism? The epimers, they have same molecular formula but differ from each other in their configuration around a single asymmetric carbon atom, but which is other than the reference carbon atom. This is the structure of D glucose. Why we call it as a D glucose? Because the hydroxyl group is present on the right side at the reference carbon atom, which is carbon number 5. And this is the structure of D galactose. And the structure of D-glucose and D-galactose, it is almost same except one difference. Where is that difference? At the fourth carbon. Here in case of glucose, the hydroxyl group is present on the right side. While here in case of D-galactose, the hydroxyl group is present on the left side. So there is difference in the orientation of hydroxyl group at carbon number 4, which is other than the reference carbon, and the reference carbon atom here is carbon number 5, but the change in the orientation is at carbon number 4, and that's why D galactose is the fourth epimer of D glucose. Now this D mannose, this is the structure of D mannose, and the structure of D glucose and D mannose is same except the one difference, which is at the carbon number 2. Here in case of D-glucose, the hydroxyl group at carbon number 2 is present on the right side, while in case of D-mannose, it is present on the left side. So there is only difference between the orientation of hydroxyl group at carbon number 2, which is the other asymmetric carbon other than the reference carbon. And that's why D-mannose is the second epimer of glucose. So both galactose and mannose are the epimers of glucose. And the galactose and mannose, they are not epimers, but they are diastereoisomers. Please note that glucose has two epimers, D-galactose and D-mannose. But this D-galactose and D-mannose, they are not epimers of each other. They are called as diastereoisomers. And what is the significance of this epimerism? The interconversion of epimers is catalyzed by the enzyme epimerase. For example, phosphopentose epimerase catalyzes the conversion of ribulose 5-phosphate and xylulose 5-phosphate. Coming to the anomerism, this is a ring structure of glucose, and here the hydroxyl group attached to the C1, this is C1 carbon atom, and hydroxyl group attached to this C1 is below the plane of ring, and that's why it is called as alpha D glucopyranose, because this is a pyrene ring, that's why it is called as alpha D glucopyranose. This is an alpha anomer of glucose. While here the hydroxyl group attached to C1 is above the plane of ring, and that's why it is beta D glucopyranose, that is the beta anomer of glucose. And the C1 carbon is called as anomeric carbon atom. So alpha and beta, these forms are anomers. What are pyranose and furanose forms of glucose? Glucose can have a straight chain structural formula, which is called as Fischer's projection, or cyclic formula having ring structure or Haworth projection. And monosaccharides in solution mainly present in the ring form. How these ring forms are formed? The ring forms can be a pyrene ring or furan ring. And this is a straight chain structural formula of glucose. So when in the solution, when the aldehyde group, which is present at the C1, it reacts with the hydroxyl group present at the carbon number 5, then it results into this structure, that is glucopyranose. And when this aldehyde group at C1, it reacts with the hydroxyl group present at the carbon number 4, then there is formation of this glucofuranose. So these are depending upon the pyrene or furan ring. There are two forms of glucose in the ring structure, glucopyranose and glucofuranose. And this glucopyranose is more stable. And both glucopyranose and glucofuranose, they have same molecular formula, but they differ in the nature of ring form. Same for fructose. Fructose can also have a straight chain structural formula, Fischer's projection. And fructose has a keto group. And cyclic formula, that is ring structure of or Haworth projection. This is a fructopyranose form of fructose, and this is a fructofuranose form of fructose. And they both have same molecular formula, but they differ in the nature of ring form. And the fructofuranose form of fructose is more stable. So in this video, we have discussed the structural aspects of monosaccharides and different forms of isomerism. In the next video, we will study about the properties and derivatives of monosaccharides.